Bitcoin. What the F is it?
How do you get it?
What do you do with it? No idea.
What's it look like? What's it taste like? Have you ever sucked on a Bitcoin before?
I just read something that it's plummeting.
It is. It's sinking like a stone. Perfect time to get on board to get yourself some. And
digital currency.
Digital currency. Cryptocurrency, they call it. There's Monero. There's that Ponzi coin stuff. Shocker, it was all a scam. And there's your Bitcoins of the world. And when last Monday, Lowell Melzer, WBAL, TV 11 News, filled in, he started talking about mining Bitcoin. Good morning, Lowell.
Good morning. How you guys doing?
Hello, Lowell.
Excited, Lowell.
Hello.
Excited.
Hello, Lowell.
You guys are insane with all this stupid stuff.
All right. I'm looking to get into a mega miner 300 unit, multiple quad core GPUs, and I'm going to link together four GTX 1080 cards. See if we can get that H&S up in the 2 gig range. How's that sound?
Sounds good to me. I think we might want to consider the 540 GTX cards, though, because they're better for mining Litecoin, but we can talk about that
later. We'll get into the Monero futures. So all this stuff is super confusing, right?
Bitcoin is confusing. We had experts on to try to explain to us what Bitcoin was. We left the conversation more confused than when we started. But you are now, Lowell, mining Bitcoin, which Bitcoin, you collect Bitcoins. And I did see that Singapore Airlines is now using, what are those things called? Chain blocks? Blockchains?
Blockchains, yeah.
Blockchains.
Yeah. I don't know what any of this stuff is, but you can now, like, I guess, buy airline tickets with blockchains or something.
Did you see that investment commercial at the Super Bowl at the bottom of it? Now with Bitcoin investment options? Like, that was, like, the big tag at the bottom of a Super Bowl ad. And you, Lowell.
Yeah, you're jumping in. Yeah. Into the deep end.
You got a computer.
Yeah. You have a computer now at your house, which is a very high-powered computer, and it runs 24/7, 365.
Basically, what it's doing, what mining is it's, you got to think of it as like moving currency and making a data record of it. That's basically what mining is. It's putting these transactions on a ledger, much like in an accounting ledger of where the money's going. That's the best, simplest way I can explain what mining really does.
Because you have to have a way of saying this person paid this person, and you and I, our computers, are these ledgers, and it basically keeps people from copying and pasting Bitcoin and using it again. Our computers are showing, no, this person paid this person once. You can't do it again with that Bitcoin. You and I are proof of a transaction, and we get like
how do you make money?
0.0001% commission.
You get a commission every time you solve a problem to move the transaction along the ledger to form a new block in the blockchain.
It's so weird.
My God.
Well, why did these transactions...
What did you just say?
We're making money, baby!
Why did these transactions take so long, Lowell? I heard the average transaction's like an hour.
Yeah, it depends which one you use. For me personally, I like Litecoin because it's very fast and it's very cheap to move along the block. I also, and there's a controversial one that I like too called Ripple, which you don't have to mine.
Like the cheap hobo one.
So how much?
Exactly.
How much have you made and how much have you lost?
How long have you been doing it and how much have you made?
All right, so I got into it at the end of last year, right before the market blew up for a week. I'm not going to say how much money I put into it, I will say my investment went up by over 100% within 2 days.
Cool.
But the currency that I bought long term, 5 years, because my belief is what we're seeing now is just the tip of the iceberg. And throughout the years, the S coins, as they call them, four-letter word S coins, will fall away, and there'll only be probably about maybe 20 left that are really considered serious. And I've invested money in ones that I think are going to be long-term. So that's what I did.
Can anybody do this?
Yes. You can, Josh, you can go on your computer right now. I can give you the MinerGate software. You can put it on and turn on your computer and just let it start mining.
Yeah, no, I don't want to do it. I'm just curious so you don't have to go through a broker. You can just do it on your own.
Oh yeah, when you buy or when you mine?
Anything.
Yeah, buying you go to an exchange like a there's several exchanges that are in that you can go to buy your certain coin.
Well, you
like
and
Coinbase. Coinbase is the one that's based in the U.S.
Let's say 5 years from now, right? Best case scenario, worst case scenario. Where does this end up?
Best case scenario, I'll quit my job and retire.
Wow. That much money you think you're going to mine?
I from what I've invested and from what's predicted, if it's true, who knows? But if it's true, I'm Audi 5000G.
Yeah, because my dog on the end of the line, we talked all weekend, and I got myself set up, and my rig is running right now. And you and I are making a little road trip soon to maybe pick up some big-ass behemoth that you and I might be going splitsies in on to start riding on a larger scale. And the model, are you comfortable with saying how much this thing
costs?
You're
going to lose everything.
I won't. You don't want to. Okay.
Go ahead.
This computer is $7,000.
Whoa! Oh my God. Jesus!
And I'm thinking about maybe buying a few of them.
What?
And networking them together, because each one could theoretically spit out $45 to $60 a day per unit. So imagine if you just had this money machine that's cranking out $180 a day around the clock all year. Once you get it paid off, man, you're sitting pretty.
It could be too
good. Isn't it too good to be true?
I don't know.
That's not to mention that, you know, you're mining at a lower price now. If you held on to that those coins that you have now and let them grow, they could be worth 5-10 times more in a couple of years.
Oh, so we're going to be so rich, Lowell.
What about the energy costs, Lowell?
Yeah, I heard
running computers
that might offset
like that.
I'm concerned.
It depends what you mine. Bitcoin uses the most energy, and then it goes down the line.
Space money.
Yeah, that is an issue, and you have to factor that in your mining costs. But if you're running rigs like Justin's talking about, it's a significant amount of energy, probably an extra maybe $100 to your power bill, maybe 150 if he's running two.
So what do you have in your house? You have a computer set up somewhere in your house that just runs and you don't have to do anything?
Basically what it's doing, it's got a program on it or something? Yeah, and basically what it's doing is it's solving math problems. It's basically, the way it works when you mine is you have a pool of people. And there are...
Buy me a rig. Put all the stuff on it. I'll pay you whatever I got to pay you. I'll pay you a finder's fee, too. Get me a rig.
Get the whole thing.
Yeah, I'm serious.
Done.
I don't want any part of it.
Thank you, Lowell.
I want to be rich, baby.
Sounds like a racket to me.
Road trip. We're all buying $7,000 Turbo Terminator Skynet computers and making a sweet profit.